Today, I will introduce to you a completely free video generation model. Its ability to generate videos will absolutely exceed your imagination. What I am showing you now is a video that is up to 30 seconds long, and this video was generated using this model. You will find that whether it is the presentation of the picture, the design of the light and shadow, or the consistency of the motion, doesn't it all surpass your expectations? This model is called Grok, and it comes from Twitter. Many people may have used Twitter, but not many have paid attention to the Grok model. As Twitter's internally developed multimodal model, it recently added the function of video generation. Moreover, the quality of the generated videos is very high. Most importantly, it is free to use and has no limitations whatsoever. The method of using it is very simple. You can visit its web version via this link. Then, we can upload one of our own images. After waiting a moment, you will get a very high quality video. The most important thing to note is that this video comes with sound. Isn't that fantastic? From what we can see, the quality generated by this model is very high. In order to give everyone an intuitive understanding of its video generation capabilities, we will compare Grok with the video generation capabilities of WAN 2.2. I built a standard WAN 2.2 image-to-video workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through runninghub.ai. In the field of ComfyEye, Running Hub is an excellent online workspace because whenever new technologies and extensions appear, they follow up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which will grant you 1,000 free points. In addition, you will also receive 100 points every day you log into Running Hub. This way, you can try out your own workflow. Let's first try using Grok to generate some conventional videos. I will try my best to use the same AI character to make it easier for everyone to compare. Compared to the WAN 2.2 model, Grok's overall dynamism is stronger. Take for example, this video of a beautiful woman standing on the rooftop. Within just 6 seconds, she first glances left and right, then reaches up to smooth the hair on her forehead, and finally turns and walks away. You will notice that within 6 seconds, the movements she makes are very rich. There is also this video of a beautiful woman sitting next to a swimming pool. In addition to the rich facial expressions, she slightly raises both arms and leans back. It looks exactly like a real filmed video. Furthermore, this model's ability to perceive the overall information within an image is also very strong. For example, the model of the beautiful woman looking at the art exhibition was designed with a movement where she gently bends down and reaches out, wanting to touch the painting in front of her. The overall performance is very agile and vivid. Of course, there is one type of video we must test, interactive videos for example. I created an image of two beautiful women sparring on a boxing ring. Let's take a look at the video it generated. It is also very impressive. Pay attention to the expressions of these two people and the feeling of impact. The overall detail performance is also spot on. I even generated some extreme videos such as a top view video and a bottom view video. We find that Grok is still capable of generating elegant and rich dynamics. The presentation of facial expressions remains impeccable. For these conventional videos, I didn't compare them with WAN 2.2. because I believe that the performance of all models in regular video generation should be similar. Next, we will use some special images for comparison. First, we have a beautiful woman standing in front of her self-portrait. The design of this image is very tricky as we have two subjects here. Let's look at the performance of WAN 2.2. You will find that the movements generated by WAN 2.2 mainly focus on the giant face. These are mostly changes in facial expression. But these movements are very conventional and lack novelty. Now let's look at the video generated by Grok. The small figure standing in front of the giant face also has great movements. Moreover, we can clearly see that there is some interaction between them. In addition to this, even considering the expressions generated, Grok is clearly superior to WAN 2.2. The next example is actually the long video generation example I showed everyone at the beginning. WAN 2.2 can also generate similar long videos. The method used, of course, is the familiar process of taking the last frame as a reference image to continue generating the video. However, WAN 2.2 has a very significant problem. During the generation process, the quality of the video continuously decays. For instance, the scene where the beautiful woman bursts through the stone gate of the tomb. The quality of the video we initially generate is very high. But if we take its last frame as a reference image to generate the video again, you will find that this drawback becomes very obvious. If we look at this video, you will see that the quality of the last frame decreases very quickly. When we use it to generate the video again, you will find that I believe there are issues with the overall image quality, the character's movements, and the overall screen presentation. But if we use the same image and generate it with Grok, you will find that even if we continuously use the first frame and the last frame to generate the corresponding video, the quality of the video, the character's movements, and the change in light and shadow will not show a significant drop in quality. Therefore, we can use it to generate a video up to 30 seconds long. Of course, if you are willing, you can generate even longer videos. This is very important as it provides us with another solution for generating long videos. This is Grok, the model we introduced to everyone today. Although this model is not open source, it is free of charge and has no restrictions. I think it can be considered a trustworthy model. What are you waiting for? Give it a try yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.